Of you have asked about my past garden videos and how some of the plants are doing out here in the garden, so I thought I'd get out here this morning and just show you how things are going. But I'm going to be honest, it's not all that great.
Well, first of all, potatoes. Remember the potato video last fall where I actually planted them upside down? Go figure.
Well, here they are, not doing so good. All right, so the leaves are really curled up, as you can tell, very brown around the edges. I think they're getting eaten by some kind of bugs. There's some kind of little teeny tiny green bug, I think some type of aphid, and like a whitefly. So these aren't doing so well. Probably harvest them in a couple of weeks. Not sure that I'll get any potatoes out of these. All right, let's go take a look at the next plant. Well, the second one I want to talk about is my strawberry pot. Now you may remember in the fall, I planted the strawberry pot up nice with a bunch of strawberry plants. And on this one, I have no one to blame but myself. I really didn't do anything with this. I neglected it. I didn't do anything really but water it, and I should have transplanted it. And you can tell here, my little strawberry plants here are dead. So I've got a couple, a little bit of green I might be able to salvage, a little bit of green on top, but this one definitely needs some attention. All right, let's go over the next one. Okay, now for my tomato seedlings. All right, I planted these anywhere from 2 to 4 weeks ago, and they are just not doing well. I think I got a problem with fungus gnats. But if you take a look here, these ones I planted on, I think the 15th of, well, this one's the 22nd of January. So they've just kind of been sitting here in the same stage for about 3 weeks. And I think it's the gnat problem. I actually put some vermiculite on top in hopes that would smother some of the fungus gnat eggs. And then I moved them outside and not doing well at all. So basically I've replanted all of my tomato and pepper seeds. They're in the house, starting to sprout, and I definitely hope I have better luck with those. Let's move on to something that's actually doing well. Well, you might remember in the fall, I planted garlic here in my red planters, and I'm really happy with how it's doing. It's growing nice and tall, hasn't got eaten by any bugs. I'm hoping for a good garlic harvest. Little side note here, I did throw a potato in, and this plant's actually doing pretty well. Got a little bit of bug damage. Who knows, maybe I'll get a few potatoes out of it. We'll see. All right, let's go. Well, I just wanted to show you this tomato plant real quick. This is my, I call it my workhorse tomato because it's been producing for a full year. It's been in the ground since last April. Still has red tomatoes on it. Actually getting some more blooms on it. Has some green tomatoes on it here somewhere. And this plant is amazing. It just keeps on going and won't quit. So I'm going to trim it up, see if I can keep it going for another year. Hey guys, remember the video we did a couple of weeks ago and how I planted cilantro? Well, here it is, coming up really nicely, got a couple little seedlings emerging from the soil. But the thing I wanted to mention was this little pumpkin here. Now this pumpkin was sitting here on the deck last night. This morning, it was here in my pot with some bites taken out of it. Now, I'm thinking this is probably a rat. We've got to get rid of this rat because I'm planting some seeds for Am I Gardener's giant pumpkin growing contest, and I really can't take the risk of that rat eating my giant pumpkin. So we gotta do something about the rat. Well, so there you have it. A little follow-up on some of my past garden videos. And as you can tell, I don't hit a home run every time. So my point in making this video is if things aren't going well in the garden, don't worry about it. Just move on, try something new, try something that works again. I mean, we all have limited time, we have limited resources, we have families, we can't be out in the garden 24/7. But the important thing is that you're growing food for your family. You're trying to be healthy, and that's the important thing. So all you need to do is just try something different and keep on growing. So thanks so much for asking how things are going here in the garden. I really appreciate that, and I look forward to seeing you around on the next video. We'll see you later.